In this video, we're going to be going over the blur feature available in STYLISM by Astute Graphics. First, I'm going to just draw out some basic artwork on my artboard. And now that I have this in place, I'm going to come over here to the STYLISM panel. And I'm going to show you this section here. This is where you're able to apply all the different effects using STYLISM. The one I want to show you is this guy over here on the bottom right. This is the blur feature. So when you click on it, it automatically applies this blur effect. Now, let's take a look and see what happens. When I clicked on this in the panel, it added this annotation here. It activated the stylism tool here in the tools panel. And if we take a look over here in the appearance panel, you'll see it added this Gaussian blur effect at the bottom of the stack. So when we click on this link, you see it's actually the Gaussian blur effect that ships native with Adobe Illustrator. So let me hit cancel to get out of this, and I'll hide this appearance panel. So what stylism does is it allows you to make changes to your blur using this annotation system you see here. So if I just click and drag, you see it's actually going to increase the pixel count. And now I have it set to 23. And when I release, you see it's actually blurred out my shape. If I click and drag and bring it towards the center, you see it reduces the pixel count and removes some of that blur. If I bring it all the way towards the center, you see it maxes out at a radius of 0.1 pixels. When I release, you see I have a very light blur going across this area here. I select my artwork again, and you saw I was able to use this slider going back and forth to make the changes. Now sometimes this slider might move a little bit too fast for the type of edits you want to make. If you want more precise editing, you could actually hold down the command key and it'll slow that slider down for you. When I release it, you see the slider goes back to its normal speed. Alright, let me show you that again. I'll click on the annotation, start to drag, and then introduce the command key. And that's what's going to slow it down for you. When I release, you see everything's updated. Now, when I hover over this guy, you see it's at a radius of 17.1. Now, if I want an exact radius, I could also double-click on this handle and then enter in whichever value I'd like. I want my radius set to 25 pixels, so I'll hit OK, and you see it's updated here on the annotation. Next, let's take a look at this resolution section over here in the stylism panel. As you can see here, it's set to 72 ppi, but I could manually enter in a new value. So I'm going to drop the resolution down to 20 ppi. And you can see here, the blur has actually gotten really choppy. Over here in the right section, you see I have some presets. If I click on this 300, it'll set my resolution to 300 ppi, and I could drop it down to 72 ppi if I'd like. This is great for editing or for exporting for the web. Down here at the bottom of the stylism panel, you'll see this curves graph. This curves graph is going to be available if you have Phantasm installed on your system. If I click and drag, you'll see it'll start to make some changes to this blur I have here. So I'll continue to make some edits. And you see I was able to soften this blur out. So as you can see with Phantasm, you're able to have full control over how this blends with your artwork. Be sure to check out future videos that cover the Phantasm graph and the resolution section in great detail. And there you have it, folks. That's the blur feature available in STYLISM by Astute Graphics.